It's coming from out there.
Hey, Bob. You're in a movie theater, not the off room in your mom's nursing home. So turn your phone to silent or I'll shove it so far up your you'll have to answer it through your...
There is no chance that that did not get you more excited for Deadpool and Wolverine.
Easy now. So much testosterone.
The next upcoming MCU project, which is going to explode the multiverse. Hey guys, it's Chris, and welcome to Cosmic Rewind, where we discuss all of the major topics that you might have missed out from major superhero news through the week. For more detailed explanation of these points, be sure to check out the videos by Warren Thompson, where he jumps more detailed into the information. But for today, we have a lot of points that we want to run through, and we're going to start jumping into them right now. First things first, let's talk about that Quiet Your Cell Phones trailer that is playing in movie theaters right now. Now, it's very intense and aggressive, and it's a perfect example of what we should be expecting when we step into theaters to watch Deadpool and Wolverine.
Nice fourth wall break back there. I didn't think you had it in you.
Shut your f***ing mouth.
No, they do.
I'm sure by now many of you have seen the trailers and the different updates that have come out. However, this week we got a very specific new update as tickets were released on Monday and it came with a new teaser trailer. Now, this teaser trailer didn't offer up too much new footage or information, but it did give us another great look at the dynamic between Deadpool and Wolverine, and they released an updated synopsis, one of which I would argue has been the greatest synopsis ever written for a Marvel movie. And it reads, Marvel Studio presents their most significant mistake to date, Deadpool and Wolverine. A listless Wade Wilson tolls away in civilian life, his days as the morally flexible mercenary Deadpool behind him. When his homeworld faces an existential threat, Wade must reluctantly suit up again with an even more reluctantless? He must convince a reluctant Wolverine to... Synopsises are so... stupid. On top of that incredible synopsis where we've really already gotten all this information, we know Deadpool is coming out of retirement to save the universe, to team up with his buddy Wolverine, who is rather reluctant, I might add. Every single teaser has pointed to that direction. We're also getting these little teaser trailers, these TV spots and promotional ones. We saw the Heineken commercial, for example, where they use Deadpool and Wolverine in a fighting scene and they kind of stop to have a Heineken. All really great stuff, all things that should get you very excited for Deadpool and Wolverine, which we'll be releasing here in just a moment.
Isn't this better than fighting?
Nope.
Moving away from the very exciting and compelling Deadpool and Wolverine news, we should talk about what was officially announced this week in a Variety exclusive, which reads, Marvel sets Vision Quest series for 2026 with Paul Bettany and Star Trek Picard EP Terry Matalas as showrunner. This comes as some exciting news because right now we are in the midst of an entire MCU reorganization period. We're no longer in the transition period from Endgame to the new Marvel world. In fact, we left that behind a long time ago, and it has been, as many fans would agree, a little bit of a rocky road. But now we see Marvel Studios and Disney picking themselves up, making a solid plan and moving forward, and we're excited to hear a lot more confirmations in a couple weeks when we get San Diego Comic-Con. Marvel Studios should stand up, explain their plan for Phase 6, but on top of this specific show that was announced, we're hoping to hear many more official confirmations. And along with the Vision Quest announcement, this also goes hand in hand with some very important Disney and Marvel update information as well that we got this week. And that is, we've been hearing Bob Iger and Kevin Feige go on and on and on about how we're going to regroup, we're going to do more quality over quantity, but we haven't gotten any clear ideas as to what that means. Well, it has recently been confirmed that what that means is you will not have to watch every single project in order to know what's happening in the MCU. It is a little bit of an exciting prospect. Now, for those of you who love the connectivity, don't worry. There will still be tons of connectivity. And it's been clearly explained that Kingpin, who's been involved in the Echo series, the Hawkeye series, will be involved in the Daredevil and Spider-Man 4 series and movie respectively. He's going to have a very important role. So how can you possibly not watch Echo to understand what's going on in Spider-Man? Well, this is the direction that Marvel Studios will be headed in moving forward with Marvel Television, Marvel Animated, and Marvel Studios. Three different divisions, all dedicated to creating amazing quality content that you do not need to watch 50 different projects before you can jump in and enjoy. It's kind of like the original idea they had with Marvel Spotlight, where there were going to be one-off projects that you could just watch on their own, but you didn't need to know the entirety of the Marvel catalog in order to enjoy it. And as we are several years into the MCU, that does seem a daunting task for first-time joiners. Imagine you had never seen any Marvel movie and you want to start watching. Well, where do you begin? Do you have to go all the way back to 2008 Iron Man to completely comprehend what's happening in the MCU today? Some would argue that you do, but Marvel's plan moving forward is that you don't. But that connectivity will still remain, as we will see with Kingpin, for example. And then, of course, it will all lead up to the big Avenger-style films where we're going to get multiple characters on screen. In fact, rumors even suggest that Avengers Kang Dynasty, or Avengers 5 as it's currently being referred to, will be a slightly smaller scale film, and that Avengers Secret Wars will be divided into a part 1 and a part 2 on a much larger scale. So the news coming from Marvel Studios is finally putting down pen to paper saying our plan isn't just quality over quantity, but we're going to make an ecosystem where anybody can watch any project and enjoy it. And I think that that's some major news coming from Marvel Studios and Disney, especially with San Diego Comic-Con just around the corner, as we are anticipating finding out what the rest of Phase 6 is, what the projects are going to be, and if there are a handful of projects there that you're not necessarily interested in, there's no obligation, there's no homework. This is actually something on the Cosmic Wonder podcast a few weeks ago that Warren and I touched on, where we said a lot of the projects feel like homework. I'm not necessarily interested in this corner of the MCU, but I feel like I have to watch in order to know what's going on. That's exactly what they're trying to solve with this change, and I'm excited to see them do it. This week, we also got an update from Spider-Man and that side of the universe. Not just Spider-Man, Tom Holland's Peter Parker, but the Sony Spider-Man, Tobey Maguire, and Andrew Garfield as well.
You're not very good at this.
I know, we suck. I don't know how to work as a team.
As you are probably aware, for several weeks, Sony has been wrestling back and forth with the MCU behind the scenes, hoping to make Spider-Man 4 a less grounded and more multiversal type movie. Well, it sounds like there's a high possibility that Sony will get this wish, and they'll have the opportunity to include Toby and Andrew to the upcoming Spider-Man 4 movie, as well as, we're hearing, potentially Venom. Now, these rumors are coming from a ton of different insiders, My Time to Shine Hello, Daniel RPK, and others who are reporting we should expect to see Venom, and we should expect to see Toby and Andrew. The question is, why? Well, Toby and Andrew apparently will be joining the MCU because once they've returned to their specific universes, they find out that Doctor Strange's spell actually has affected their lives as well. And we know Tobey Maguire Spider-Man had a family, had a wife, finally put all the pieces together. So for him to come home and not be known, I imagine is devastating, and you would assume his only life's goal would be to return to the 616, to the Tom Holland Peter Parker universe, and get it fixed. So that's going to leave Andrew and Toby trying to return through the multiverse. And then, of course, with Venom, we know from the post-credit scenes in Venom 2 and from Spider-Man No Way Home that Venom has left a piece of the symbiote there, and there will be some reconciliation from that point of the story, according to insiders. Hopefully, we see Tom Holland and that piece of the symbiote connect, and we get the Secret Wars original story where Spider-Man originally has the Venom symbiote before it makes its way over to Eddie Brock. Now, that's all up in the air, and we're basing most of this off of rumors and insiders, but it sounds like we can move forward confidently, hoping that at least to some degree, Andrew, Toby, and Eddie Brock, whether by Tom Hardy or not, could be involved moving forward in the next Spider-Man movie. We also have some news on the X-Men front. Deadline originally reporting that X-Men movie at Marvel Studio gains momentum as Michael Leslie comes on as screenwriter. Now, this exclusive report states that following the success of its animated series X-Men 97, Marvel Studios is now ramping things up on its live-action X-Men movie with Hunger Games: The Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes scribe Michael Leslie in negotiations to pen the movie. The film is still in early development with no talent or director attached and no release date set. Marvel Studios president Kevin Feige will produce. So based off of a lot of the news that we've gotten from this week, we can tell Marvel Studios is very much looking to the future, but in a very positive way. And this has really been a big turning point for me as a consumer and as somebody who follows the news deeply. I've seen a little bit less desperation in these reports and a lot more hope and inspiration. I think as of recently, there's been a lot of pressure on the executives at Disney and Marvel Studios to come up with a plan, and I think they might finally have one. All of these reports are pointing towards a positive future, positive creation, positive writing, and putting things into a higher quality standpoint. So moving forward, we're seeing a lot more excitement coming from Marvel Studios, which hopefully will equal better and more fun projects for us all to enjoy moving forward. But we are extremely excited to hear what you guys think about all of this news. What are you most excited for? Deadpool, Wolverine, the X-Men, moving forward with new MCU projects and plans, the Vision Quest series, all of this news from the week before. As I mentioned in the beginning of the video, if you'd like to dive into more deeper detail, please go check out the videos from the week that were put together by Warren Thompson, and let us know what you think in the comment section down below. Don't forget to subscribe so we can get to 1 million subscribers, and I'll catch you guys in the next Cosmic Rewind.